is the news from rural and regional Australia. I'm George Gregan, captain of Rugby Union's victorious ACT Brumbies. A successful casino beef week wound up on Saturday with the naming of a top stud bull. The lead stud competition was won by exhibit number 49, a magnificent 900 kilogram Charolais White, who pleased the judges with his high scoring duality of muscle and softness, his solid frame and ample bollocks. Judges say they chose those attributes to satisfy trends for the housewife and trends for local trade.
The judges become very, very aware of the trends for the housewife and trends for the local trade.
The year of the volunteer is being embraced by rural communities, with unpaid citizens stepping in to help local police. The volunteers in the police unit, known affectionately as VIPs, came together last weekend for their annual state conference in the New South Wales town of Wagga Wagga. The VIPs spend hours in the office, freeing up sworn officers so they can do more important police work, much to the gratitude and amazement of the police.
They get no money, they get a corporate uniform, we've just given them a hat, but really, that's all they get.
Recent reports of a panther-like creature in Lithgow have prompted similar sightings all over the country. Residents of Coolatai claim that a black panther has roamed the area since 1958. Now the story of the Coolatai panther has been immortalised in the song by Tamworth's John Grills. It only took John Grills a day to write the song after interviewing locals about the mysterious creature that has kept them guessing for 50 years.
Oh, yeah, there's one here, there's been one here. We haven't seen it for a while, but there's one around the area.
John's song has already picked up the prestigious Queensland Gold City Award for Best Song. He's planning to launch his new album in Coolatai next month. In sport, a huge result for regional Australia on the weekend when I captained the ACT Brumbies to victory in the Super 12 final. The 36-6 win over South Africa's Durban Sharks was the first ever triumph in this Southern Hemisphere Championship Series by an Australian team. Victory in the very physical match played in Canberra was set up when winger Joe Roth went across for his second try early in the second half, off my pass. And today, 12 of the Brumbies, including me, were named in the Wallaby squad to play the British Lions next month. Bill Young was also named in the squad. Unfortunately for the courageous big man, he had to withdraw after an MRI scan revealed a fracture to his knee joint. And finally, 40,000-pound parcels of Australian cattle have been selling at 73.55 US cents per pound, which is firmer than last week's price. While 40,000 pounds of live hogs is fetching 67.45 US cents per pound, down slightly on last week's close. That's this week's news from rural and regional Australia. I'm George Gregan, captain of the competition winning ACT Brumbies.
Very well read, George, and I'm just wondering if you brought the silverware in with you from the big win on the weekend.
It actually came up this evening on the highway, and it's just arrived in time.
Look at that.
Right,
there
we are. Fantastic. Hold it up there.
Look at that.
That's fabulous. How does it rate as far as other trophies go that you've got your hands on? Is it as good as anything you've got your hands on?
It's a pretty special trophy,
Yes.
And, you know, we've been working at it for a few years and we finally got there.
Yes, this is the first Australian win in this competition, I think I'm right in saying that, and the competition has been running for about 6 years now. Now, look, the Sharks came with, as you mentioned in the report, a very physical game. I thought they were being un-Australian in the way they played that game. We've got a clip here of one of the players having a go at you. I think it might be the opposing captain. Let's have a look at this. Way off the ball. He goes on with it, he tries to hop out of you, and then he gets you up and flattens you like that. Now, some people find that attractive, but it's not really within the rules of rugby, is it?
No, that's going, you guys would say, going the knuck.
Yes, that's right.
Off the ball.
That's right. How did you feel when he did that to you?
I was a little bit dazed at the time. But the good thing was we got a penalty and Andrew Walker kicked the goal, but I wasn't feeling the best straight after that.
Right. He kicked 8 from 8, I think, didn't he? It was an extraordinary night for him.
Yeah, I think he's missed one goal in the last two games. Yeah. He kicked well in the semi-final for us against Queensland too. Yeah.
Now, speaking of Queensland, previous week, we have a bit of footage here of Owen Finnegan doing much the same manner to the Queenslanders as was done to you. Let's have a look at this. There he goes, in on the, I think that's Michael Foley he's having a go at the head of there. I think there's Michael getting, trying to get the ball away. He can't. Of course, Owen sees the head as the ball, and unfortunately just misses it with his boot. It's an accidental thing there. Wouldn't you say? He didn't mean to do that, did he?
That was totally accidental. they're very good teammates for the Wallabies, and I think he... just timing. The ball was near his head and he unfortunately was a little bit out in timing, as forwards tend to be.
That's right. He was trying to anticipate the fact that the ball was going to go forward towards the boot and it didn't go there, and it would have been in the right position for a strike like that.
Yeah, it went the opposite way.
Yeah, the fact that he'd sharpened his studs earlier on with the file had nothing to do with it. George, I don't mind the Sharks coming out here from South Africa and playing like cheating bloody mongrels, as they did. What incenses me is the standard of refereeing. It was appalling. I don't know, the referee might have been a New Zealander, but the refereeing was a national disgrace, an absolute disgrace to world rugby. Would you see it that way?
Well, you're right, he was a New Zealander and he was from the South Island.
But it was a disgrace, wasn't it?
It was rubbish.
It was rubbish.
It was rubbish.
It was absolute rubbish. No yellow cards.
Where were the yellow cards?
Shoulder charges, they're not legal, they were doing it all night. The tackle on you, no yellow card.
Exactly.
Would, in normally, with the same referee, would that player who tackled you in that manner be sent off?
Well, I think he went on the touch judge's report, and I think he was going for his yellow card, and the touchy came in and told him,
said,
you know,
nothing in it.
Penalty.
Yeah. Oh, penalty. Mm. Yeah. Right, right.
Now, you've been named vice-captain of the Australian team. You will be captain. When's Eels going to retire? Because he's getting a bit old and slow, isn't he?
I'm not too sure with Eels. He just keeps going. And, you know, he had a slow start to the year, and I think he's jumping out of his skin for the domestic series against the British Lions and also the Tri-Nations. He'll play as long as his body holds up, and he's playing really well.
And you look forward, though, to the vice-captain duties. I mean, you're following the line of great halfbacks who've been captain, Nick Farr-Jones, Ken Catchpole. Now, yourself, can you see yourself being captain at some stage?
If I got the opportunity, it'd be absolutely great, Roy. It'd be fantastic.
You'd love that.
There's some good leaders in the team.
Yeah. Does it get up your nose that a lot of people in about 60% of the viewing area of this program don't understand the difference between rugby union and rugby league? Yeah. Does that annoy you? Does that baffle you?
Yeah, it really does irritate me. Yeah. Gets up my nose like
you
wouldn't believe.
What do we do about it?
Do we need clinics actually, around Australia, especially in the AFL states, obviously Victoria, South Australia,
South Australia,
to explain the difference?
Explain the difference. Get them into a ruck. Get them into a maul.
Yes.
Explain the difference between that and a play the ball.
Yes.
Exactly.
Right.
And are you enjoying seeing some of these rugby league players come over to rugby union?
Fantastic. Andrew Walker, Peter Ryan, they played in the grand final for us. They were outstanding.
Yes.
And it's been really good. It's good for Australian rugby.
Yes.
And just give us an idea now with the British Lions coming. What's the nature of the program there? Is it a three-test tryout with the British Lions?
Three tests in a row, starting in Brisbane, and it's going to be tough. The majority of that British Lions team is from England.
Yes.
So they had a fantastic year this year in the Six Nations.
Yeah.
And it's a big challenge for us, but the guys are really looking forward to getting into them.
Do they play like the South Africans, i.e. cheating, mongrel bastards? Are they bastards?
Well, like majority of them, as you would call them, they're the Poms. And
the Poms. Like you hate them? You hate them?
Zero didn't like them.
Yeah, no, he didn't. No, do you hate them?
We don't like them either. We don't like them, so we want to beat them, Roy, in HG.
Well, we look forward to seeing you, buddy. Bash them up, but good.
Three blocked.
Yeah.
And you've just, off the field, you've had enormous success as well. You know, life's going very well with you because your first child has arrived. And I think we've got a snap of you with the little kitty in the hospital here.
George, is there just a hint of green and gold about the kitty?
When you hold him up to the light,
can you see
the window,
the green and gold?
Can the green and gold there?
He's got my you, and I think he's going to probably look more like me.
Yes.
I think
you're not answering
in
the
terms
question.
Of...
Can
in
you
terms
see him in the forwards, in the backs? Where can you see him playing?
I'd like to see him at a golf club or a tennis racket in his hand if he goes away sporting
yes,
wise.
Yes, of course.
But we'll have more to wait and see. Well, there's less sort of running into people, yeah, which is
yeah,
good.
Yeah.
George, all the best with young Max and the near future with the British Lions and the rest of the career and so on. And we'd like you to take away this souvenir of the show, the flapping dunny belt buckle. I think I've got to turn it that way slightly. And maybe this could go on the shorts in a tryout against the Lions and see how it goes, if it works.
Yeah.
Maybe play with it in a test.
Yeah.
In the meantime, I might ask you to look down the camera here for a happy snap and ask the audience to thank George Gregan.